This is a tutorial on doing metric conversions using exponents or powers of 10. When faced with a question like 468 centimeters is equal to how many kilometers, using exponents makes your conversions much easier. To start with, you'll need to have access to a table that lists the metric prefixes along with their associated units. Here we have mega, which is 10 to the 6th, kilo, which is 10 to the 3rd, centi, which is 10 to the negative 2nd, milli, 10 to the negative 3rd, micro, 10 to the negative 6th, nano, 10 to the negative 9th, and pico, 10 to the negative 12th. These are not all of the metric prefixes, but these are the ones that are most commonly used in chemistry. We're going to start out by putting our given in the first box of a factor label, 468 centimeters. When doing a factor label and conversion using exponents, I find it easier to put everything into scientific notation, so we'll go ahead and change that number to 4.68 times 10 to the second centimeters. The next thing we want to do is make sure that our units in the next box on the bottom match the units of our given. That means that those will cancel out. Whenever doing a conversion, we always go through the base. So we're going to initially convert into meters. What we're looking for here is the relationship between meters and centimeters. And that's actually given by the exponent. When using exponents and powers of 10 to do metric conversions, the power of 10 always goes with the base unit. So we're going to put a 1 in front of centimeters, and this is times 10 to the negative 2nd. In our next box, because meters is not the units we want to end up in, so in our next box on the bottom, we're going to put meters. Again, this means our units will cancel. We can go straight from meters into kilometers, so we'll put kilometers here to finish up. And again, our power of 10 always goes with the base unit. So 1 kilometer is 10 to the 3rd meters. Now we're going to move all of this down to finish our multiplication. This gives us an answer of 4.68 times 10 to the 2 plus negative 2 minus 3. 4.68 times 10 to the negative 3rd kilometers. Let's practice another one. Here we have another problem. 26.4 megaliters is equal to how many milliliters? The first thing we want to do, of course, is put our given into the first box of a factor label. And the second thing that we want to do is convert that given into scientific notation. 22.64 times 10 to the 1st megaliters. Now we again want to place the same units down below and in the next box as are given so that they'll cancel. And we're going through the base unit again, which is liters in this case. Our next box will have liters in it to cancel, and then we'll go into milliliters. Now it's just a matter of filling in our powers of 10. Remember that the power of 10 always goes with the base unit. So 1 megaliter is 1 times 10 to the 6th liters, and 1 milliliter is 1 times 10 to the negative 3rd liters. So now when we put it all together, we have 2.64 times 10 to the 1 plus 6 minus negative 3. What does that give us? That gives us a final answer of 2.64 times 10 to the 10th megaliters. What about a case where we're going from one very small unit to another very small unit? Should you count decimal places? Should you try to just move the decimal? I advise against it. So even in a case like this, I advise students to go through the base unit and then back to the number they're converting to. Again, we start with our given, 4.1 picometers, and we want to make sure that our units in the next box on the bottom will cancel, so we're going to use picometers again. If we're going through base unit, this is going to be the relationship between meters and picometers. And our final box will relate meters to micrometers. Okay, picometers cancels, meters cancels, we end up in micrometers. That's where we want to be. Let's plug in our numbers. So, 1 picometer is equal to 1 times 10 to the negative 12th meters. And 1 times 1 micrometer is equal to 1 times 10 to the negative 6th meters. This gives us 4.1 times 10 to the negative 12 minus negative 6, or 4.1 times 10 to the negative 6th micrometers. Not so hard once you get the hang of it. And that's about it. So if you remember these four tips, you should have an easy time with these. Put your given in scientific notation in the first box. The units in the next box and below should cancel. The exponent always goes with the base unit and always go through the base. That's it. Good luck.